Okay, assalamualaikum and a very good morning to Sir Othman and my beloved friends. Today we would like to present about Anabas testudinus, or is also known as climbing perch. This presentation will be presented by me, myself, Syazwani binti Luqman, and my friends, Syazwani binti Luqman. Do you guys know what is Anabas testudinus or climbing perch? In Malay, we are familiar with ikan puyuh. So, our focus today is the speciality of this Anabas testudinus. But before that, let me introduce to you about Anabas testudinus. Its kingdom is Animalia, which means that it is an animal. And then its phylum is Chordata, which means that it is vertebrate animal. Then its class is Actinopterygii, meaning that it is classified as bony fish. Its order is Perciformes, which it is classified under the class of perch-like fish. Its family is Anabentidae, which means that it is a small spiny fin fish. And its genus is Anabas, and its species is Anabas testudinus. And in this world, there is only two types of Anabas species, which is Anabas testudinus and Anabas cobogius. This Anabas testudinus speciality can be seen through their habitat. This Anabas testudinus is classified as highland fish, and second, it can tolerate extremely unfavorable water conditions. This Anabas is classified as highland fish because it can live in different places. And this Anabas usually found in the lake, canal, swamp, pond, and also estuaries. Do you guys know what is estuaries? It is actually the borderline between the saltwater and the freshwater. It is quite rare for us to find the fish that can live in different salinity of water, but this fish can do so. Then, second, it can tolerate extremely unfavorable water conditions. It is because it can live in water that is low in oxygen, and also the water that has been polluted. Let's say the water are being polluted and low in oxygen, this Anabas can still survive and live in that water because of the special accessory organs, which later will be explained by Syazwani. And then, this Anabas also are able to estivate for several weeks during dry seasons. Meaning of the estivate is that it can, during drought season, it can bury itself under the mud to keep itself moist, so that it will be able to survive also in the dry seasons. Then I will pass to Syazwani to explain about the characteristic of this Anabas that makes it special.
So now I will explain about the characteristic of Anabas testudinus, or in a simple word, we call it as climbing perch, or in Malay, we call it as ikan puyuh. So, from the name, we already know about the behavior of this fish. So, the first one is, this fish is loves to travel and climb the trees. This fish is actually frequently found on treetops, and it always found hanging from trees. There is a story. The fact about this fish can climb the trees until the top is actually only a myth. The true story is actually the bird caught this fish and put them on the top of the tree. So why we call it as a climbing perch? Actually, this fish can climb from the surface of the water to the root of the tree. It's actually only at that stage, not until at the top of the tree. Then, actually, what we call this fish, they love to travel because actually it is native from Asia, where Yowis to China and to Wallis Island. So what made this fish love to travel and climb the trees? Actually because of its spinal fins and gill plates where they can move quickly along the floor, and they use both of these to climb up. So my advice, if you keep this fish at your home, if this fish does escape, please don't limit your search to the vicinity of the tank, because remember that this fish can walk. So please don't be surprised if you found this fish a longer distance away from your tank. So for the second characteristic, this fish can survive without water for several days. Actually, this fish can survive for a few weeks and also until a month, as long as this fish have their gills skin-wise. So what made them can survive without water for several days? First, they have an accessory edible organ where, as the term, these fish gills must be moist to survive. Then the second one is actually because they have lungs that are similar to human. It allows this fish to breathe air on land. So at the end of this presentation, what's so special about Anbas testudinus? So it can be concluded that first, it can live in different places. Second, it can tolerate extremely unfavorable water conditions. Third, they can travel and climb the trees. And fourth, they can survive without water for several days. So that's all from us. Thank you. So you guys got any question regarding this presentation, which is Anbas testudinus? If not, so that's all from us. Thank you.